Here in McGill's chemistry department, we constantly look for new, more efficient, and green ways to synthesize new products. The less waste, the better. In many chemical reactions, what we'll first do is we dissolve the reactants, mix them together, heat the big bath of reactants and solvent up, and then get rid of the solvent afterwards and have pure product. We've decided to go another route and skip the solvents. Instead, we've been mixing the solid reactants, into our milling jars and grind them up using a milling machine. This is called mechano-chemistry because we use mechanical energy to induce a chemical reaction. So the ball bearings are used and are put into the jars. The jars are shook around. The ball bearings hit the side of the jar, cause very large amounts of force and heat, and this results in a chemical reaction. And this new technique will make our lab more sustainable. One problem that we've been working on is the reactivity and separation of metal oxides. Metal oxides are constantly formed when metal is reacted with oxygen in the air. So there are many different types of metal oxides, and many of them have very good uses. Cobalt oxide is a really nice blue pigment. Zinc oxide is used in sunscreen. Lead oxide is used in car batteries. One of the more common metal oxides that most people know of is iron oxide, which is rust. There's a constant demand for these metal oxides in today's modern technology. A big problem is that when mining, what we dig up is not a pure product. It's a mixture of products. So we will dig up a mixture of many different types of metal oxides or many different types of metals. Separating these different metal oxides is a very inefficient and expensive and energy-consuming process, and it results in a lot of corrosive waste. Due to their stability, activating metal oxides first requires very strong acids or bases. We've been looking for an alternate way, a cleaner way, to activate these metal oxides and separate them using mechanochemistry. Our goal is to find a reaction that reacts one metal oxide but not the other, so that when we react it, it will make a soluble complex, and one metal oxide will be able to be dissolved, and the other one will stay undissolved. So we do this reaction, we dissolve it in chloroform, and then we filter off the solid waste, solid leftovers. The liquid that we collect is our dissolved product. These processes will make the lab more sustainable and could contribute to a potential solution to separating these in the mining industry.